Welcome back, everybody, to part 3 of episode 2 of The Wolf Among Us. Though I think I'm just going to continue with the part order. Still same recording session, so I haven't really done anything yet. We found out that Snow's alive. Whoa. Did not see that coming.
Well, that's appropriate.
Swords through the hearts. Is that protein powder?
The moon. Usually this is about deception or confusion, but for me, well, who knows?
Yeah, I'm a wolf. I like the moon. Right?
I hope you can find what you're looking for.
Oh, right. You can just look at them. They're antacids. Not exactly.
Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought.
Or maybe he's a murderer and he's feeling a little guilty over it. I feel like that's something that might give you a little indigestion.
Snow's perfume.
Lea Loa. Does it smell good? Talk.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
I feel like seeing the body first will be beneficial when asking TJ's questions. If he found the body. I think he did. I think they said that. Want to explore, but I don't know if I, if this is my only chance to explore. It probably is. So, I'm gonna walk around. Maybe do a little nothing this episode. Hopefully I won't get into another tirade about Pamela or some other literary figure. Like Don Quixote, which I think is generally considered the first novel anywhere. I think it was a Spanish novel, if I remember correctly. I haven't read it. I know the general gist of it. Maybe this Snow White, the one that's alive, not this Snow White, that Snow White.
I didn't realize. I've never seen her face before now.
You gonna be okay?
Maybe she's glamored.
Have to stay.
I want to stay.
Maybe she's the real villain.
It's just a little strange. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do.
Does it wear off at all?
I don't wear a brooch like that.
Really belong to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
We can look it up, I'm sure.
Looks just like Faye should.
So gruesome.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faye?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests.
Look at the face.
If the neck wound was the same, there might be a ribbon in her mouth, too.
But the ribbon was Faith's, so,
anything?
Yeah, no. That doesn't really make sense.
So, it's not exactly the same.
Can you close her mouth?
Vanity. I mean, it makes sense.
Thanks.
You don't want your dead body to be looking silly.
She got your perfume right.
How would she know? How do you know what perfume I wear?
Lea Loa.
This knows. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk.
Do you see that?
Could be a bruise.
Okay, I guess I got everything from that. Oh, ankle marks. Ooh, let's start down here. We can work our way up the leg.
She was tied up?
There were cinder blocks tied to her ankles.
Cinder blocks?
So she would sink.
Oh.
Was she found in the river?
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms. Or if they're trying to hide the marks.
Anyway, well, let's look at her arms.
Means it's not a perfect match to your leg. Unless...
Don't be ridiculous.
Maybe she was trying to compensate with that perfume.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
Yeah.
Might be a cheap one. Just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So maybe there should be.
Black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
Hmm. Good catch. Let's look at your fist first.
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No, she's holding something.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe.
Let's pry it open.
What
we gotta see
doing?
What's in there.
Only way to find out.
Oh, jeez. I'm gonna, like, break off her fingers or something.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it?
A flower? Purple flower?
Flowers?
Yeah.
Considering how dead the body looks, that flower looks pretty nice.
You're right. These buttons are wrong.
You'd think it'd be crumpled and discolored, too, if her body's already looking like that.
Snow, do you mind if I open her coat?
Bigby, just let me do it.
Do I get a watch? Am I going to have to blur something? Okay.
You still okay?
The underwear struck me as a funny detail. Because, I mean, she's right there.
Took longer than expected.
I wonder if she's wearing the same kind. Or if that's a...
Her glamour's defective.
Oh. Defective?
We are thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yeah. Big government, everyone. Woohoo!
We should keep going.
I gotta.
Are you wearing silk lingerie, Snow?
Why do you want to know?
Just trying to see if the clothes are exact.
They're not.
Let's check the pocket. This one.
What is that? She had the perfume with her. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions.
Yeah.
I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic. The witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous.
You may be right.
One yeah.
To find out.
What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
Might want to stand back if you're worried, Crane. I'm gonna try to open it. Something to do with these rings here.
Oh no, I have to do this? Let's make the horse. Oh, it's an elk.
A deer. What does that mean? Oh.
A locket of her hair, a photo of her. So it's like a voodoo kind of stuff, right? Well, I mean, you know, with those little dolls, you attach the hair to them, and you stab them with a pin, and then the real person feels it. What are those just called voodoo dolls? Yeah, I think so. I don't think real voodoo, well, someone real, with the quotations around it. It is exactly like that. If Supernatural is anything to believe.
This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore.
Rose? Snow White has a sister?
She's a troll?
You've got to be kidding me.
She's pretty.
Yeah, she's a troll. Can we move on?
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
With that tattoo, it's gotta be Holly's sister, Lily. The woodsman told me about her.
You're right. She was reported missing, but...
Oh, God.
I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
Do you want to talk to TJ first?
Yeah, yeah, let's talk to CJ.
I do.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
We'll fill you in later.
Good. Good.
Okay, I'm going to end the episode here. Well, in the next part, we'll go talk to TJ. Thanks for watching, everybody, and see you in the next one.